Trigonometry Unit Section 1. Trigonometry is a branch of mathematics that involves working with triangles. Some basic knowledge of trigonometry is useful to anyone in a technical field, such as mechanics, construction, graphics, and many other fields. There are four varieties of triangles that we will use: scalene, isosceles, equilateral, and right. We'll now review each type. The first one we'll take a look at is a scalene triangle. And as you can see, each side is a different length. And because of that, each interior angle is a different measurement. We see scalene triangles in many real world applications. Here we have a truss, and it's showing us the two different scalene triangles. The next triangle we'll look at is an isosceles, where the base angles are equal. And because the base angles are equal, the sides opposite those base angles are equal. When you have an isosceles triangle, we have two sides that are exactly the same length, and the angles opposite those two sides, which are called base angles, are equal. Here we have a blueprint, and if we blow this up, we can see here on this upper left-hand corner an isosceles triangle. They're giving us that this side is a quarter of an inch. If we blow that up to look at it further, we have an angle of 45 degrees, and given that this is a 90 degree, the remaining angle, because the sum of the angles in a triangle is 180, this third angle has to be 45 degrees. We now have two base angles that are equal, which means we have an isosceles triangle, and the left side length of this triangle then will be the same as the top, the two equal sides, 1/4 of an inch. We see isosceles triangles in multiple places, and here we have an example of some rafters where there are clearly isosceles triangles on the hip portion of this rafter. Here's an example where we're looking to solve this isosceles triangle. Because we have the two base angles equal, we know that the side angles have to equal one another, that are opposite those base angles. And since one is 5.8, it means the other angle opposite that base angle also has to be 5.8 centimeters as well. If we're given lengths of an isosceles triangle, we know that the opposite angles of these have to have the same measurement. We'll use the fact that the sum of the angles in a triangle equals 180. Even though we're looking for two angles, we know that those two angles are equal. We'll take our 180, subtract the 22 from it, which gives us 158. And because of our isosceles triangle, these base angles are equal. We will divide the result by 2 to give us the measurement of each of those base angles, which turns out to be 79 degrees. The next type of triangle we'll look at closely is an equilateral triangle, which is a triangle where all three sides are exactly the same length and all three interior angles have the same measurement. Since all three sides are equal, their opposite angles would be equal, and 180 divided by 3 is where the 60 degree measurement is coming from. Multiple applications for equilateral triangles. Here are a few. Because the triangle is a very strong arrangement, we see it in multiple applications in construction as well. Next, we want to take a look at defining what an altitude is, and it is a straight line drawn from a vertex in a triangle to the side opposite. The line is drawn so that it meets the side opposite at a right angle. Here, because of this vertex, it turns out that the altitude is inside the triangle. Here we have a little more extreme triangle. When we're drawing an altitude from this vertex, it ends up we have to extend the opposite side so that we draw a perpendicular, which is a requirement of the altitude. Altitudes sometimes, when drawn from a vertex, are actually a side of a triangle. If we were drawing an altitude from this vertex, we want this to be a straight line to the opposite side that forms a right angle. And because this is a right triangle, it ends up that it just runs along the side of the triangle. Having an altitude drawn in an isosceles and an equilateral triangle, for that matter, have some interesting and useful properties. So here we've drawn an altitude. What it does is it bisects or cuts in half the vertex angle. It originally was 100. We now have each of these two parts are 50 degrees. Furthermore, it bisects or cuts in half the opposite side. The total opposite side was 18 inches, and now each of these two segments, because of that altitude, is cutting it in half. The other property that happens is that it forms two equal right triangles. And here we see in this construction here for this bridge, we have our isosceles triangle with that altitude and support there in this construction. Common roof truss. Here we have the overall truss is an isosceles, and here's the altitude called the king post for this particular truss. If we have an equilateral triangle and we draw the altitude, same thing occurs. It's going to bisect the vertex angle, it will cut the opposite side in half, and it will form two equal right triangles. If we're interested in finding the length of this bottom side of our right triangle from that altitude in this equilateral and the angle measurement, we're going to use those properties of the altitude. Because this is an equilateral triangle, all three angles are 60 degrees, the altitude bisects that vertex, which means our measurement is going to be 30 degrees in our right triangle that we just formed. And the opposite side, when an altitude is drawn, gets bisected. So to find the length of this side of a right triangle, we'll divide 25 in half or by 2 to give us a 12.5. Right triangles have, by definition, a 90 degree angle, and the side located directly opposite that right angle is called the hypotenuse. It is the longest side in a right triangle. The two sides that make up the right angle are called legs. And again, we have right triangle applications in multitudes of places. Here the kingpin is forming a right angle combined into a triangle. To help us solve triangles, we can use a Pythagorean theorem, given that we have a right triangle. In this example, we have two leg lengths given, and the question is, what's the hypotenuse? So we'll use a variation of Pythagorean theorem, which allows us to compute the length of the hypotenuse. We'll replace the leg lengths with the values from this example. Order of operations, we need to square each of those values, in other words, multiply them by themselves, add them together, and finally take the square root. So the missing length is 126.3. Another version of use for the Pythagorean theorem is when we have the hypotenuse and a leg and looking for another leg. Here's the variation of Pythagorean theorem that will help us solve this problem. It begins with taking the hypotenuse, or the longest side, multiplying it by itself or squaring it, and then subtracting the one leg length that is given once it's squared from your hypotenuse squared. So the particulars for this example, you can see the hypotenuse value there squared minus the other leg given. Complete the subtraction, take the square root, and we now have the measurement of our third side or the second leg in this right triangle. You're now ready to try some of these skills in practice set one found on pages 6 through 8.